Hey guys, for the past 6 years, Jay Burkhalter has organized the ball. He was the PR person for the Firefighters Union until Monday, when he was relieved of his duties with the union. He says the ball is supposed to be a positive event, and he does have a message for the chief.
Sorry. I feel bad that all this is coming down on him, and that after all the good things he's done the last 10 years, hopefully this doesn't tarnish what he's done for us. I think he's a good chief.
Jay Burkhalter says the Denver Firefighters Ball has always been a place for fire personnel to let off steam. It's a private event that recognizes the work of fire crews, gives out scholarships, raises money for charities like a children's burn camp, and honors retirees.
It's a big event. Unfortunately, this could be the last one. And so I feel bad for that and you know, not letting those guys kind of get what they deserve, you know, at the end of their career.
Burkhalter says last year's event got uncomfortable after he brought out a sex toy called Manny the Fireman and pointed out one of the fire chiefs had the same name.
It made the rounds with different people, and it ended up, you know, hitting the guy on the head or being used as a microphone. The way it's hard because the trust's been broken.
Burkhalter says this year he tried to prevent what happened in 2019 and even apologized during his opening monologue. He says he hired a comedian to lighten the mood, but then she cracked a few jokes about sex toys in her bit.
I guess I can see that being possibly offensive, but there was no, that was it, you know, it was just part of the comedian skit. We hired a professional comedian hoping to avoid kind of what happened last year and shed light, make fun of ourselves and move on. And it kind of, I guess, just opened old wounds.
Burkhalter says the fire chief had nothing to do with organizing the event and no control over the comedian's jokes. He just hopes the true spirit behind the private firefighters ball doesn't get lost as a result of this very public situation.
I think that in today's, just the way society is, it's tough to do things that make everybody happy, but in a private light, you know, and so there's a fine line there.
Now, Burkhalter says he's been a firefighter for nearly 3 decades and calls the department a family. He says trust was broken here at this private event, and he hopes this doesn't mean the end of good things, the celebrations of the hardworking men and women at Denver Fire. I'm Lori Jane, Gliha, Fox 31.
Yeah, they definitely should be celebrated. Lori Jane, thank you. And that comedian who performed at this year's ball, known as Kim Wadsworth. Wadsworth says she was specifically asked to make a reference to Manny in last year's ball during her 20-minute set, but she says it was just a very small portion of her act. Wadsworth then sent us this statement, which reads in part, "Our men and women in service to our community should not be observed under a microscope when they're at an event meant for camaraderie, fun, and relaxation." She goes on to say, "Did it cross a line? Not in my opinion." Well, Fox 31's Kagan Harsha spoke with Wadsworth, and he will bring you more of that conversation tonight on Fox 31 News at 9.
And the problem solver is learning more about the fire chief's sudden decision to step down. Investigative reporter Chris Koeberl has been trying to get answers from the city. Chris?
Yeah, and late tonight we're being told by the mayor's office that this move came as a complete surprise to them.
Chief Tade is a 28-year veteran of the Denver Fire Department. The problem solvers were all over the city today to get reaction to the decision. The fire department canceled an on-camera interview at the last minute. The local fire union that put on the annual ball told us everyone was out of the office when we stopped by. As for what happens next to fill Tade's position, sources close to the mayor tell the problem solvers changes are coming this week within the fire department. This is being done in conjunction with the director of safety. There was never an assumption he's not effective. However, he believes a change is needed.
And late tonight, we did receive word from that firefighter union. They say they take complete responsibility for what happened at that ball. Now, it's also important to point out that Chief Tade is not out of the fire department. Instead, he's taking on a role of assistant chief. Reporting live, I'm Chris Koeberl, Fox 31.
All right, Chris.